Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, Issa Vlog. How's y'all doing today? I am currently eating cereal, Cinnamon Toast Crunch. What's your favorite cereal? Comment down below. Today, we're just gonna have a regular vlog. It is not workout day, it's actually work from home day. Today is Thursday the 10th, okay? It is currently March 10th. I have no idea when this vlog is gonna make it out. I have absolutely no intent in putting these vlogs out in any chronological order, so, you know, doesn't really matter. It's not like I'm doing anything that important. I'm gonna have some little mango yogurt. These are so good, y'all. These are from, I guarantee you this is in Spanish. It's sad because considering that I grew up around so many Hispanic people, you would think that my Spanish would be fluent, but no, I lost it as soon as I went to college. So it says peva, and everything else is in Spanish. But I guarantee you, if you see this label, it's good, okay? I love this shit. And it's a mango flavor. It says manga, but it's mango flavor. It had pictures of mangoes. I know y'all clicked on this video because you're like, girl, what's going on? Let me try not to chew my mouth full. Let me tell y'all the bullshit that just happened to me. So, for the past couple weeks, I've been suffering from extreme anxiety. The reason I've been suffering from extreme anxiety is because my shit has been on a decline. And I ain't never in my life suffered such a decline except for when I take a break. When you usually take a YouTube break, usually your shit will be kind of stable, but it'll go down a little bit. This shit right here, bad. I'm talking about like my subscriber count is at a negative. So I'm just like, I ain't never seen nothing like this. Everything's going down. Subscriber count going down, view count going down, revenue going down. I ain't poor, I ain't broke, but I'm headed there. So I'm like, okay. At first I thought it's cause I've been changing up my content lately, but it ain't even been that bad. I ain't quit cold turkey. I'm still doing reactions. I'm still talking my shit. I'm still doing social issues. So it shouldn't even be that bad. I don't understand what's going on here. So I was like, you know what? Before I go crazy, before I go to my therapist about this thing, okay? Before I start screaming bloody murder and start telling everybody to take out their pitchforks against YouTube, let me contact these people. I literally heavily debated it because there was one time where something like this happened to me similar, and I realized it was because I deviated away from my original content and I kind of tried to do a content change, but it was nothing on the back end. It was for me not doing the content. Like, I contacted them and they was like, you know, there's no glitch on our end, you're good. This time I was like, you know what, let me try to figure it out on my own. And then when I realized I was posting like the shit that like made me pop, which was honestly like the parent reactions, and I realized like that shit was not going anywhere, like it was like if anything the same, like probably worse, I was like, all right, I'm contacting YouTube. I contact YouTube and this is the response I get. My channel is in restrictive mode, y'all. Listen up, if you have a bigger channel, you have access to contact YouTube. You have like a specific email or a specific chat feature on your channel. Never think that you cannot contact YouTube and they will not help you. They will investigate. They will let you know straight up, okay? If you ever get hacked, if you ever have a situation where you can't figure something out, they will help you, okay? It may take weeks, months, days, years, but they will help you, trust me. If you are a bigger channel, I don't know if it's been like decreased yet, because I know it's always been like an 100K plus feature, and some channels that have 100K plus followers end up having like a YouTube manager that they can actually go to when they have issues like this. I'm annoyed because I don't have one yet. Like, they let me apply for one and I got denied. But when you're over a certain amount on YouTube, which is like over 100K, unless they lowered the bar, you can contact YouTube for issues like this. So now my channel is in a restrictive mode, which means all of you that have been contacting me like, oh, I'm not getting your notifications, this is why. Because I have like over 50 to 60,000 people that have my notification bell turned on and they're not getting those notifications. My assistant has my notification bells on her subscription so she can put my new videos in the Discord and she don't even get those. So it's like, this shit don't make no sense. Meanwhile, my Haitian channel is doing just fine. It's normal. Nothing is weird there. The revenue's fine. The subscriber count was fine. Like, everything is normal. But like, this main channel is just, I don't know, it's out of whack, it's all over the place, and it's so irritating because no one told me about this. I ain't getting no notification, I ain't getting no email, no nothing. To be honest, I'm happy that it wasn't like my fucking monetization that was taken away, because y'all, that's even worse. Because if your monetization gets taken away, you have to wait like a whole month in order to even apply to get the monetization back. That's bad. I didn't want that. So I'm grateful. I'm happy that it's not me. I'm happy that it's not my monetization being stripped and I'll have to wait a whole month to apply again. And I'm happy that it's their mistake, okay? I'm happy that it's their mistake because this don't make no sense. I'm trying to like see what I'm gonna do now. I don't know if I'm gonna take like a little break, because like at this point it's like, what the hell am I posting videos for if nobody's gonna see them? And then on top of that, it's like, why am I going to sit here, waste my time, if I don't know how long my shit's gonna be restricted? And then it's like, I need to figure out where this happened. Like, was this back in the day? Like, was this now? Like, I want to know when this happened. I'm beginning to think it could have been during my story time and chill. It could have been a word that I used. It could have been a succession of videos. Like, you would have thought that this would have happened when I was posting like a lot of the parent reactions, but this couldn't have been it because I stopped posting a lot of those a long time ago. Like, I just started posting some of those recently, so it wasn't that. It had to be either a story time or I don't know, a Kevin Samuels reaction. I have no idea what I would have posted that would have triggered it. But like, YouTube is so tricky. Like, there could be something that you use in your tags, something that you use in your description, something that you use in your titles that can literally like trigger the whole thing. And I know there's gonna be people like, oh my god, it's because you're black. It has, y'all, please don't. Don't. We're not gonna do that, because trust me, there's plenty of white YouTubers this happens to. People make these videos all the time about stuff like this. I'm very sure it has something to do with something that I did in terms of like a tag that I used. This is why I kind of stopped using tags for like over a year on my channel. My channel was just fine, but no, I tried to use tags again thinking it was gonna help me, and now look at where I'm at. I should have never. It's probably a tag that I use. I'm very sure it's a tag that I use, because I don't even remember. Like, I'm like, it had to be something. It had to be something where like something was age restricted, and like it just restricted my whole channel. So now I have to look, I gotta go find shit and like appeal my channel. I'm gonna try to do it by the end of today. See, strategize, figure this shit out. I'm so annoyed because it's like, what is the point? I need another vacation. Maybe if I do a puppy dog face, he'll take me to Mexico again. Maybe I could get like Cuba. I'm so spoiled. Yeah, I'm like, babe, let me style. He gonna see this and be like, this what she be doing? No, like, I'm actually really upset though. Like, I actually got over it. I got my rant out on Instagram. I already did tell him about this, but it's like, I'm actually genuinely annoyed. It don't make sense, because it's like, when things like this happen, like, YouTube will not tell you. If you guys are not aware, there was a time where YouTube had ratings, and they had this thing where you were able to inspect the page. Guys, this is like such geek talk. So you were able to like right click on your computer and see what YouTube's rating was for you. I was rated T. I don't know how the fuck I went from being rated teen to now I'm restricted. But like, if you were rated mature, or if you were rated whatever, like, your shit got like barely any ads, you were barely suggested, whatever the case may be. Interesting, because now they kind of like, they figured out that people were figuring out what their rating was and kind of like playing into the system, and they kind of restricted anyone from being able to do that. So it's like, you know, it's little shit like that. So it's like, when things like this happen, they don't tell you, they just go about their business, and that's a fucking issue, especially when these things are being done by automated people for the most part, or like it's being triggered by something. I could have honestly pressed something. Like, I wouldn't be shocked, because there be times I'm in a rush, and that's a problem on my part. Like, I be in a rush, or I just be trying to like go about my business, and I just be clicking shit. Like, now I'm just so annoyed, because I'm sure it could have been something that I did. But just like YouTube be having these automatic processes that put people in these restricted modes, they need to have automatic processes that send people these emails to confirm that these people are in these restricted modes. This shit is so sad. Like, y'all, I'm so sad. But it is what it is. We're gonna see what we could do. So today, I'm not really doing much. I think I'm gonna work on some choreography. I'm gonna take a walk. I have a The Mafia Speak session. I have maybe some planning to do, but I don't even know what my plan is about to consist of because of this shit. So it's like, yeah. It's a very chill day today. Tomorrow, I'm probably going to be doing a photo shoot. I don't know. It's a depends on how I feel. Depends on how I feel, because I heard it's gonna be like 50 degrees, which is a little bit warmer than typical, considering it just had a whole bunch of snow and rain and sleet yesterday. New Jersey weather is so bipolar. Comment down below if you have bipolar weather too. It's problematic. I'm gonna check it with y'all later. I'm gonna finish eating my cereal that's taking me way too long to eat. I have not had an appetite, mainly because of my meds. You know, I was dumb enough to stop taking my meds like an idiot cold turkey, because, you know, as a bipolar person, that's the bullshit that we do. We just stop taking our meds because, yeah. Shout outs to my mentally ill people, especially my bipolar people that like to just stop taking our meds for no apparent reason. Yeah, don't do that. Don't be stupid like me, because I suffered really badly after a while. So yeah, now that I'm back on them, one of my medications that I take is Topamax. And if you guys are not aware, Topamax is also taken for weight loss. A lot of people who take Topamax have like a really, really suppressed appetite. So it's very hard to know when we're hungry, and it's hard to remind ourselves to eat. Like, I could literally just eat one meal a day and be completely fine, because like I don't know what to eat, which is very unhealthy. So I have to like remind myself, or sometimes I have to like remind myself in time intervals. I'll be like, oh, 9 a.m. let me eat. Oh, 3 p.m. I should eat. Oh, 6 p.m. let me eat. Oh, midnight snack. You know, I have to remind myself. So I'm gonna finish the cereal, yay, and head to the freaking YouTube dashboard. I don't even want to see the damn YouTube logo right now. That's how annoying I am. So comment down below if you're having issues with your channel. I'd love to hear about it, because we're here, we're one in the same ring. So hi guys, sorry to interject, but I just decided, please head down to the description box right now and or the pinned comments and go subscribe to my backup channel. I don't know what I'm doing on it yet, so yeah, it just mean a lot to me if you guys just go subscribe there, just in case anything happens to this channel. I would much rather be prepared than be unprepared. So yeah, that would be really amazing. So yeah, let's get back to the rest of this vlog. Say hi to the people, Sage. There you go. Good kitty, yay! Yeah. All right, y'all, so we are in the lay office now, and we are going to be working on trying to figure out where my channel went wrong. And I just realized I forgot to take my vitamins and my medication. It's so sad. If I ever have to take like medication to save my life, like yeah, my mental health medication is important, but like if I ever have to take like medication that like my life depends on it, like if I don't take it, like I'm gonna die, because I could never remember. I'll take it in 2 seconds. Probably not, because I'm sure I'm gonna forget again. But anyways, I'm actually going to schedule my The Mafia Speaks first. Gotta pick a topic that I feel like talking about. Usually I kind of do this like days in advance. I usually never do this the same day, but I mean, y'all be alright. Y'all know it's on Thursdays, right? Y'all should know that by now, right? Y'all should know that it's on the same day at this point, because it's usually on Thursdays unless I say otherwise. So let's see. Oh, we can talk about relationships. So we're just gonna do that. And please don't try to climb the desk. We're gonna schedule that. I'm gonna take my meds, and we're gonna get it popping today. Okay guys, so I've been chilling, watching the videos that Milagros has sent me to review before I post them. There's only about two, because I actually been doing very well at actually watching them and posting them on time. So I'm watching a Zodiac video, so you guys seen it here first. It's actually 30 minutes. There are some changes, so I'm watching it right now on Google Drive. I do need to submit the appeal to YouTube still, so I'm probably going to look at that form again. I'm actually waiting for them to respond to me, because the appeal is kind of for age-restricted videos, but my whole channel is kind of like restricted or like age-restricted. So I don't know if I want to wait for them, if I kind of want to wing it, and I don't know. So I'm kind of trying to see. I don't know if I want to wait a whole 24 hours for them to respond. Like, my anxiety is through the roof. So I do have to go grocery shopping, but my live is at 7, and I don't want to hit traffic, even though like the grocery store is down the street. I really hate traffic. When I tell you, I have no patience for traffic. I have no patience for lines. I have no patience for bullshit. So I'm debating on like just going now and then coming back and doing that. But I'd rather just get it out the way now. Look at Sage. You want to come up? But yeah, I'm kind of trying to like figure out what I want to do. But I'm definitely going to take you guys with me to the grocery store. So we're going to do that in 2.5. I'm going to let y'all know. I'm going to see y'all when we out. All right, happy morning everyone. It is Friday, which means it is gym day. I typically usually skip this day, I'm not even gonna lie. Sometimes I'll like go on a Thursday, or I'll like work extra hard or do some Insta reels and like compensate, because I don't know what it is, but like something about filming reels or like dancing to compa or something like that will make me extra tired, and it'll compensate for a workout. The fact that I'm going in on Friday is shocking. So it's like 8:30, I'm gonna actually eat something, have some beetroot powder, which is typically a good pre-workout. So if you get like extra jittery from like regular pre-workouts and stuff like that, beetroot powder. And I love the taste of beets. So I'm already dressed. The outfit for today, I do have this Puma hoodie, and it says only the great see. I love this hoodie so very much. Like, I just love
Puma. Like, when it comes to workout gear, my first is Nike, okay? I'm gonna say it straight up. Nike, then Puma, then Adidas. But I like Adidas to get cute, okay? Adidas is my athleisure, okay? I like to walk around in Adidas. I don't really like to work out in Adidas. But it's a good dance fit. Like, if you're really into Zumba, if you're really into, like, just dancing overall, Adidas is where it's at. Regular workout is high, but Nike, Puma is lit. And then I have these leggings. Very comfortable, amazing. I got these from Marshalls. I think these are dance skin leggings. I love these. I need to get more of these. I absolutely adore these leggings. And they're an army print, and I'm gonna wear my Puma shoes. I try not to trip set. If I'm gonna wear Puma type of shirt or whatever, I'm gonna wear Puma type of shoes. If I'm gonna wear Nike type of shirt, I'm gonna wear Nike type of shoes. I don't try to trip set. And I do have these ankle supports today. Trying them out from Amazon. I have like really bad ankles because I sprained my ankle back in high school, and I refused to wear the damn crutches. And now my ankles are suffering for them. So yeah, very sad life. If you ever sprain your ankle, don't be like me. Wear your damn crutches, okay? So since I'm gonna be dancing and I'm gonna try to do the Stairmaster and stuff, I'm really gonna keep these on today. So we're gonna try these out. If not, you know, Amazon return policy on clutch. So as a after gym snack, I'm gonna have a banana bar, which is sweet and salty peanut. These are from Aldi. They can be compared to the regular, there you go. Good little granola bar. And then these, they're also from Aldi's. These shits is rocking. It's really important to have like your meal like right after the gym, because that's when you absorb the most protein and nutrients and stuff like that. And I usually be delaying the hell out of getting back home, and then I gotta cook and stuff. So soon as I come back home, I'm going to cook some pad thai. I have no idea what pad thai is in English. I just know what it looks like. I'm gonna have to like figure out what it is, because in Creole it's pad thai. But I'm gonna actually make some salmon for lunch, but I gotta have to like get it to room temperature. But it does defrost pretty quickly. This is from Great Value. I got it from Walmart. So we're gonna have some patat and salmon. It's kind of like a sweet potato type of situation. I'm gonna show y'all it when I figure out where I put it, because I put it somewhere. Luckily, y'all have no vermin issues. Look at this. Ooh, child. See, this is what influencers don't show you. This is real and raw. So luckily I don't got no bug issues. So I'm just gonna throw these in here while I go to the gym. For those of you that's like, why don't you hand wash them, bitch? Cause I have the privilege. Okay, I have the privilege of a dishwasher, all right, motherfuckers? So I'm gonna do that, eat my breakfast, and head straight on out. So here is the beetroot powder that I use. My man got this for me a while ago. I absolutely love it. It doesn't clump up. It doesn't have a taste. So you're gonna have to add your own little sweetener to it. I like to add milk to mine, but today I'm just gonna have it with straight water. That's probably like, what? Yeah, it's a common Haitian thing. We add milk and sugar to everything. As you guys see, these are macros. 15 calories, 3 carbs, 100 grams of potassium. So it gives you a nice little energy boost, a natural energy boost at that.
All right, y'all, so we are in the gym now, and we're gonna start stretching. Whew, it took me a while to get here. I was talking to my man on FaceTime. He had some amazing news, but I'm not gonna share it yet because he hasn't shared it with anyone yet, so it's not up to me to share bae business. So anyway, that actually helped me lift my spirits because I'm happy for him. He's gonna be making some really important changes soon, so we're just gonna stretch. I'm gonna put this on a tripod or whatever, and yeah, let's get to workout. After my workout, I usually take this time to like brush up on my Zumba choreo and then make up some new choreo, and then I work on some Insta reel stuff, like if I see any challenges that I want to learn and post and stuff like that. So first I'll brush up on Zumba choreo because I already know that stuff, and if you never see my Zumba choreo on Instagram, that stuff is intense. I'll burn like a good 200 to 300 calories off of one if I do it full out. So do that first. And then, you know, I go into anything that I want to learn for Zumba, then I'll do Insta stuff last because that's a lot shorter. To test these, I didn't do the full thing full out. These aren't bad. That is one of my high intensity.
All right, y'all, so I am now in the car because I decided to leave the gym a little early. I left around 12:30. It's about to be 1 now. I'm gonna eat my little gym after snack situation, then head to the supermarket. I might think about probably heading out in the morning early instead. It depends on how I feel, to be honest. But I had to leave because my feet feel crazy from them foot compression things. Like, I might have to return them. Like, they're a little bit too compressive. I might just have to get a different size. Like, I got a small, I might have to get a medium. Like, y'all, like, my feet feel crazy. Like, I think they might be turning blue. So I had a pretty decent workout. I was really sweaty, but I had to turn the AC off, so now I'm kind of dried up. And I just had to wrestle with my little car tripod I had bought for this camera. This shit, that shit is getting returned. I don't know if I'm gonna return it today or later on, because like, I do have UPS near me that I could return it at. It depends on how I feel. I'm not in the mood to be outside, to be honest. I've really been very depressed, and it's not even over this, just lately I just don't be in the mood to do shit. So we're gonna see where the day takes us. I do have to go to ShopRite though, so I'm gonna eat, then head to ShopRite, see what happens, watch some court shows while I eat my little snacky snack, and yeah, I'm gonna check in with y'all later. So they have these pretty flowers in a jar. I might just do that because they're $13. I don't see why this is $13. I get some fake flowers, go to Dollar Tree, get a damn mason jar, and do that shit myself. Oh, $25. Mom loves her candy, and she loves Oreos. So, $25 is max though. All right, so cake options. My mom likes any cake, so this shouldn't be that hard. And it doesn't really matter if her name is written on it or not. These are happy birthday cupcakes. Oh my god. I like $8.49. I like cheap. And these are like more like specialty cakes. So I decided to go with this one because I'm not gonna be tempted to eat it. I don't really care for filling and all of this goofy shit, and it looks less kid-like than the cupcakes, so. Okay, so we got the cake, Oreo birthday cake. My mom is like obsessed with Oreos. We got a pack of candy. This is a big pack of candy. Skittles, M&M's, Snickers. She likes these candies as well. These is from my man because he loves M&M's, and I think he would enjoy this. It's the peanut M&M's. I don't understand. People who eat these are demonic, in my opinion. I think these are disgusting, but hey, he enjoys them. And these are for me and him. So this is what you're getting, and I'm gonna go pick up a little balloon. Here are my feet. They're not swollen. They got the little marks on them from the like sleeve, and they're kind of, I don't know if you could tell, because like my feet are so damn white. It's so weird. My body is so much lighter than my face. It's so annoying. But like, you can tell, I don't know if you guys can see, but like right here on the inner areas, they're so much redder, and like my feet look so damn wrinkled and pressed. I have to get a bigger size, y'all.
Alrighty, so I just washed my booty and now here is the vegetable that I was talking about. I really don't know what this is called. If I figure it out, I will put it on the screen, but it's pretty sweet. I would say it's similar to a sweet potato, but less sweet than a sweet potato, but kind of like a regular potato. I absolutely love this. I used to eat this all the time when I lived at my parents' house. So I'm only gonna have one. I'm gonna cut it up and boil it in regular water. And then I'm gonna have some salmon. I'm just gonna pan sear the salmon and season it lightly. Probably try to make some sort of sauce out of it. And I'm definitely gonna clean because my house is a utter mess. So we're gonna do all of that. And then I'm going to prepare some rice chicken soup so that I have something to eat for the week and stuff, because like I'm the type of person where like if I don't have food ready to eat, I'm just not gonna eat. So then I just sit there and starve, or I'll just want to go order stuff or go eat fast food. So I'm just gonna have some chicken soup ready. I already have some pita. I love to have my like soups with pita. And I'm gonna start cleaning and debate if I want to go to my mom now or if I want to do that in the morning. So yeah, I got some shit to do. Then I'm gonna sit down and work on my media hustle site because I've been procrastinating that for way too damn long. So I want a very lightly seasoned soup. Like, I don't want a lot. Like, I feel like sometimes I be going a little overboard. Like, I be trying to be Chef Boyarivana and it be too much, okay? It be too much. And sometimes I just want some basic bitch shit. So what we're gonna do is we're probably just gonna go in with adobo. Trusty dusty adobo. And we're gonna probably do something else, onion powder, and I want something just exotic to top it off. I said exotic. Can spices be exotic? I think so. I think that basil. I think that's different. A little bit of basil, and then we're gonna mix it all up, and we're gonna let that sit before we put it in the Instapot. We're gonna use a trusty dusty spatula, courtesy Dollar Tree, the bowl and the spatula. Bruh, how y'all feel about Dollar Tree being $1.25 now? I feel like it's so disrespectful. So disrespectful. It smells so nice. So it's gonna be great. And I'm gonna put a tad bit more basil in the soup and a little bit more adobo, or maybe a tad bit more salt. It depends on how I feel. So you guys can see, I don't know if you can see that, but like the outer rim, it's kind of pulling away a little bit, like you can see the outer like lining. So yeah, the skin will come right off. Alrighty, so we got my salmon and my pap tart is fini. Ooh, so good. I'm probably really gonna only eat half of this. I decided to put some spinach with this because I needed some vegetable. It's ridiculous how much this shit cooks down. This whole thing was overflowing, y'all. Promise you, but it cooks down so much. I was gonna throw some more in here, but I said fuck it, I don't have time. I only used some green seasoning for this, and then for this I used some sea salt and some Cajun style Louisiana, well, spicy Louisiana classic. There you go. It's not spicy at all, okay? It just gives really good flavor. I promise you. So we're gonna get the Instant Pot out and finally put this in. It's been sitting for about like maybe 45 minutes to an hour. This shit, like all the water's gone. That's how you know, okay? Like all this shit's been sitting for a minute. So this is almost done. Can't wait to eat it because I'm hungry. It is 4:56, bro. All right. Put some tartar sauce on the side. Patats, spinach, and salmon. I love it. I cannot wait. I was supposed to have this like 2 hours ago, but I was dragging my feet. All right, y'all. So I actually did go to Elizabeth. I gave the gift to my mom. She liked it or whatever. I accidentally left the camera.
Oops. So we're going to check out Lay Soup. It's looking good. Shout out to the Instant Pot for keeping it warm for 2 hours and 24 minutes. And it's looking so nice. Look at that chicken and rice soup. Looking nice and chickeny and ricey. Now, I was supposed to clean. It's looking real slow because I'm so tired. It's already 8:44. That's not late, but I try to get in bed by like 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock the latest. And it usually takes me about 2 to 3 hours to clean. You guys are like, what the fuck? Really? Yes, it does. And I'm really like still kind of annoyed. Yo, I'm telling you, a little bit of rice goes a long way. I probably didn't even put half a cup of rice in this shit. And there's so much rice in here. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my god, but I'm gonna have some rice and some pita, and we're gonna end the vlog for today, and I'm gonna see y'all tomorrow. Okay, y'all, good morning, good morning. It is now Saturday. I am chopping up some veggies and fruits and organizing them. I'm one of those. I do have to do this in order to actually eat my produce, because if not, it just sits in the fridge and it don't get eaten. Okay, so for the photo shoot, here is what we have. So this outfit is something I've been planning for a while. I bought this shirt on Shein, and as you guys can see, the whole middle is exposed, okay? So, but I have a whole idea for this. This outfit is solidified. I'm gonna do this on a warmer day, so we're gonna be taking shots on two separate days. And then for this, it's gonna be an indoor shoot, and we're gonna mismatch the outfit. So we're going to do the jean jacket with both these shirts, and we're gonna do the black joggers with the black jean jacket with probably just the red shirt. It depends on how I feel, but all of these pictures are gonna be indoor. I have like a set of stairs in my house, like, cause I have like a private entrance. So I'm probably gonna take those pictures inside, but I definitely have to plan that before I waste my time and do all of this goofy shit. But these pictures are gonna be taken outside the front of my house because I already had the idea for this for a while. You have to plan what you're doing, because if not, everything is gonna fall apart. So I'm gonna figure that out today. Hey y'all, so it's the next day. Let me just say I suck at vlogging really badly. I forgot to vlog me cleaning. I forgot to vlog me cooking. I forgot to vlog bae. I apologize. But it's lengthy. Y'all got some stuff. So I'm thinking about taking my hair down because I feel like it's starting to look a little crusty. The thing is, I really hate the fact that every time I say my hair looks bad, it don't look that bad on camera. And I be feeling stupid when I take it down. And I do have pictures to take. So now I'm thinking like I probably shouldn't take it down, because like all I gotta do is like sway my baby hairs a little bit, and I think it's gonna look a lot more decent. So I'm probably not gonna take it down. What I'm probably gonna do is grease it. And I'm gonna talk to y'all a little bit. And then I actually just got a new vlog camera. So y'all know I'm actually trying to take this vlog thing very seriously, okay? I'm trying to take it seriously. So we're gonna unbox that a little bit later. So of course, if you guys have not already done so, make sure you guys head to the description box and or the pinned comment, and you go subscribe to my backup channel. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet, so please don't ask me. I'm just trying to deal with this crisis before it gets out of hand. I still haven't got word back from YouTube. It's now Sunday, so they said they're gonna get back to me as soon as possible. Oh my god, my face looking crusty. I kind of just woke up. So yeah, they said they're gonna get back to me, so I'm just waiting, and I'm trying to deal with the crisis as best as I can. And I think a backup channel makes more sense to do like now. So please subscribe to the backup channel. It's linked down below. Thank you so much if you do so. And yeah, so we're gonna get into that. Alrighty, y'all, so I'm in the bathroom. We're about to get the gressy on. My boyfriend's telling me how good I did on the food. Yay, I really wish I would've cooked for y'all. I need to make sure I turn the camera on, y'all. That shit is so hard to remember. Like, so today, because my hair is so dry. I don't know what my stylist used. Y'all know I already told y'all, like, my hair never flakes. My hair never, like, I never go through any of these issues. Like, my hair is never dry. My scalp is never dry. Now, it be snowing. It be snowing. Like, I be having a blizzard. Okay, it's not a blizzard. It's not a blizzard. But it be snowing sometimes. So, we're just gonna go in with
some Haitian castor oil, which I didn't really feel like doing, but we're gonna do it anyway. This is gonna leave a white cast on my hair, but I think I need it. Like, this shit crazy. I really did want to take the style down. Like, I was really kind of getting tired of it, and I kind of had a shoot idea. I kind of wanted to be like all up in my hair, like awesome. Easy breezy cover thought, no? But yeah, I don't think that's gonna work, so. For those of you guys who have locks or who have braids in or anything like that, anytime you see your hair start to flake, you see dandruff, moisturize, bro. Now, the sad part is it's gonna be very hard to grease this because, oh my God, like under here, it's like so itchy because that's where the style is. Like, it's a bunch of hair just bunched up, nothing being touched here. That's the only sucky thing about certain styles, like you can't reach your hair. Honestly, I was thinking about, like, before I was getting the braids, to like get two strand twists. Like, the reason I never got two strand twists is because I felt like it's gonna make my hair shrink and I felt like it wasn't gonna look good. But now I'm like, I got some length to me, you know, so it actually probably won't look bad. So now I'm like, I might as well get some two strand twists, give my one last retwist, and then get braids for the summer. I'll be going on 2 years locked. Haitian castor oil is good for your skin too, y'all. Sadly, it doesn't work for my eczema, but for those of you who have eczema and you tried everything, try Haitian castor oil. My skin and my body's just resistant to anything. It's really fucking annoying, actually. Like, but Haitian castor oil is really good for a lot of stuff. As you guys can see, I have my clothes laid out. I do have to take some Instagram shots. So this is gonna be a whole separate video because a lot of you guys are always like, oh my God, how do you take your Instagram pictures? So this is one outfit. I've been planning this shoot for a while and it's actually gonna be pretty hot on Friday. Y'all know this weather bipolar, okay? One day it's snowing, next day it's 70. So 70 degrees is gonna be 70 degrees on Friday. So I'm gonna take these pictures Fridays. As you can see, it's kind of open. So yeah, I can't be out here trying to catch pneumonias. All right, so that outfit is for Friday. That's for a whole separate day. Yeah, this week is gonna be a picture week. I don't think I'm gonna be filming since I kind of have to like re-strategize and figure out what I'm doing because YouTube's playing games in my life. So basically, yeah, that's what I'm about to finna figure out. So lots of blank walls in my house. I do that purposely. For those of you guys who are trying to like design for your apartments and stuff like that, make sure you do that. Lots of blank walls, lots of blank space is very important. For me, it's just aesthetic purposes of like, how about if I'm gonna take a picture on a blank wall? And if you guys know anything about when I first started YouTube, I love to do my videos on blank walls. So that's another reason. So say good morning. Say good morning. Okay, so you're feeling rude today. All right, that's nice. Right here would be a very interesting place to take a picture. I could crouch down. Okay, do y'all see the vision? Oh, dope. Do y'all see the vision? See, I'm giving y'all like glimpse of the video before the video because I didn't even figure it out for the video yet, but I could sit right here. See, that's sun. This is why you gotta have to like plan these things because you see how the sun is hitting here? It's not gonna work out unless I literally close all my blinds. But this color right here is gorgeous. Like, you gotta be real creative with these things because no one would know that this is under my damn counter. Of course, y'all know because y'all watch the vlog, but nobody would know this is under my damn counter and I'm next to freaking two bar stools. So, but this actually would look pretty damn tough. I could also just sit right here. My piano's actually in there. I'm supposed to be learning. I ain't dedicate my time to that. I've just been really off and depressed, y'all. I thought about a couch. You know, I've been like thinking about doing a couch photo situation for mad long and I have not done it because my couch covers, I have to have them on because of Sage, her hair, and I don't want her scratching up my couches. So I just always have the couch cover on. And it's really annoying because I'd have to take the whole couch cover off, take the pictures. One day I'm gonna do it. Let's see, what we got in my office? I need to redo this office, I'm tired of it. I need to do an office tour one day. If you guys really want it, I'll probably do it on the Media Hustle page though. I need to do a house tour too. That will be a vlog in itself. So we're gonna do the unboxing in 2 seconds, don't worry. This is supposed to be my wall of inspiration and motivation. I'm supposed to be filming in front of it, but the problem is most of my, I'd have to use this lens. I don't usually use this lens to film. I use a whole different lens and it doesn't take up all the wall. But this actually works very well. And I wanted to put like the cards that you guys send me around too. Like I'm trying to figure out a way for it to look good without it looking crazy. And you know, I'm always in my head and I'm a perfectionist. So
for me, it looks crazy. Let me adjust this real quick, guys. Yeah, I don't want it to look crazy, so I just be mad in a way. Let's get into this unboxing of the Lou vlog camera situation, because this is just too big to be holding all the time. It's distracting, and plus I don't want to break it. This is my main YouTube camera, so that's why I invested in a different like vlog camera. I mainly, actually, the funny thing is I bought this camera specifically just in case I wanted to vlog, and I bought this at the time where I even contemplated vlogging. That's the crazy part. I bought this with the intention of, oh, I'm gonna start vlogging one day, let me get this camera. And the crazy thing is I never started vlogging, which is weird because that was my intention. I don't know what happened, but yeah, that was my intention. When I started vlogging with this, I realized this shit is way too big. Like, it's small compared to like a DSLR, but it's too much because people just be looking at you. It's annoying as fuck. And I wanted something more discreet, so I got a DJI Pocket. DJI Pocket in here. We have some accessories that I bought for it here. Now, to be honest, all else fails, I got 30 days to return it because Amazon's clutch. I don't got time. I order everything from Amazon. Shout out to my Amazon babes. As you guys can see, this is small. The whole entire camera is in here. Now, what's really good about this camera is it is a camera and it is a gimbal, which means it could follow me around. So, like, say if I'm doing a dance video, say if I, like, want to, like, put this down and, like, you guys want to watch me clean or something like that, this will follow me. It's lit in terms of, like, so I want to do a how I shoot my videos. I was like, how the fuck am I going to do that? Like, I do have a camera and I do have a phone, but the quality is going to be significantly different. So now that I have two cameras, well, I do have my T5i still, but it's way bigger than both of these things. So it's like, it's going to work out a lot better because this has a tracking on it. So I know there's a lot of debates that say the DJI Pocket 1 is better, but personally, I'd rather get something newer than older. And I'm probably not going to use like the tracking as much. I don't think I'm gonna use this for like dancing. I don't know, who knows? Here it is. Ooh. See how small this is? It's perfect. I can fit this in my little bags. It's discreet. It comes with a little microphone, had a little tripod and all of that. And here's the pocket. Now, one thing about me is I research. I watched probably every DJI Pocket video on the internet. And I mean, luckily I'm not doing no extreme sports. This has been compared a lot to the GoPro, but apparently this is a very fragile camera. It's one of those things where, like, if you are doing extreme sports, you have to be very, very careful with it because it will break. It's beautiful. It's perfect. It's, I'm in love already. This is so damn small. Now another con I know I did see about this was you have to set this up like online via the app. They don't let you like use this without setting it up online. So that is a privacy concern for a lot of people, but it's like, I ain't got shit to hurt. Oh my God, look at it. Oh, it's so cool. It's already moving. Connect to phone, activate with DJ Mimo. So you can skip it 5 times. So we're gonna probably do that for the purposes of this video. Now, oh wow, this is sharp. Oh, I'm about to be vlogging. Oh my God, it's lit. Let's make it track this. There you go, now the tracking's on. As you guys can see, it's moving and it moves with you. It is so lit. I love it. It's so cute and adorable. So now I could vlog without having no issues, without worrying about my freaking lens. Cause I'd be so afraid. You know how many times I dropped that camera? Dropped it a lot. And you could connect this to your phone via right here, and you get a bigger screen when you connect it to your phone as well. As soon as you connect it to your phone, it goes this way and you can see everything on here. You can control everything on here. This is the case. Shoot, I should have got a gimbal for my phone, honestly. But vlogging on your phone, listen, you could vlog on your phone, but it's just so much storage wasted. And then you have to import the clips, and sometimes the clips don't work out, child. I don't got time. So, of course, this is the little piece that goes at the bottom. And this allows you to connect it to a tripod or anything else. This is a little all-in-one piece, which is tough.
Now, one thing I saw about the reviews for this camera, people kept saying that taking this little piece off the bottom was so difficult and it was so hard to do. I don't know what the fuck people are talking about. I took that shit off mad easily with nails. I thought I was about to have to wrestle with this. It was not that hard. I'm just shocked at how good of quality this all feels, and I'm happy that this all stands on its own. You guys cannot see that. There you go. It all stands by itself. This feels nice quality. I thought this was fucking plastic. For how expensive this little thing is, I ain't gonna sound like all of this is low-key expensive. I would expect for it to be quality, but we all know sometimes these places be letting us down. This goes down here just like any other little tripod thing. I thought this was gonna be plastic. It's actually a nice little fine metal piece. Actually, I'm not gonna connect this now because I probably won't connect this to anything ever. Unless, you know, a car tripod. It is so cool. Look at how the gimbal is just moving and moving and moving. Now, this is the microphone. The microphone wirely attaches to you. And this right here, I don't even understand what this piece is. Oh, this is the regular bottom piece. Oh, wow. This can be attached to the bottom regularly without this, like, extra magical wand. we be calling this shit a wand because it just makes it so much longer for absolutely no reason. Someone comment down below if you have this camera and it came with a wide-angle lens when it came to the all-in-one creator kit thing, because I'm a little confused. And that's another annoyance that I don't like about this. Everything is so damn little. Look how small everything is. It's like playing dollhouse, eh? The bagay o pitio. They're so damn small. I mean, there's a nice little manual, which, I mean, who reads these?
Okay, y'all, I found the rest of the pieces in the box.
Came with a smaller box. Listen, don't judge me. I'm gonna have to watch one of those demonstration videos. See, now those I didn't watch. I just watched reviews because I'm confused as to how in the hell this is supposed to clip on, dude. There you go. Now, I keep forgetting what this fuzzy thing is called. There's a real name for it. Ah, the wide angle lens. I did get it. Yay. Now, you see how small all of these pieces are? I'm afraid that I'm gonna lose all of this shit.
Nobody said that in any of the reviews. So apparently, there's this thing right here. Boom.
And you can put pieces there, I guess. You could remove them and put pieces there. I'm very irritated because I thought that this part came already on the camera. I was about to say, like, where's this piece at? But apparently, you have to move it. There's another piece that's also supposed to go there. So when I want to use the damn piece, I gotta freaking move pieces. I gotta play Tetris with these pieces. I can't tell you how annoying and cumbersome it is to have to, like, oh my God, I wanna wear this purse, but I can't because I have to worry about my camera and if the camera's gonna fit, and then my lens, I have to disconnect the lens. Y'all don't understand. I think that's what really deterred me from vlogging. It's the preparation. It's the thought process behind it. And when you have your phone, it's easier because it's like, oh, I just pull out my phone. But the problem with the phone is the post process. Like, especially with the new iPhone, I don't know what it is, but like when I had to edit my Mexico vlog, when I'm telling you I wanted to die, it was the worst process. It was the worst process because I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's like the setting. I don't know if it's like the new firmware. But when you put the new footage on your computer, it, like, you have to correct every single clip. So it's like, it's a nightmare. It's like a whole extra step now when you're importing those clips. It's not as easy as it used to be. So, and then of course it's the whole storage thing and you have to keep track of the clips. And then it's a lot to vlog on your phone. So now I only do small clips on my phone. Like if I leave my camera, the camera die, that's it. But I don't do it no more. I was like, I can't do this. I can't. So now, you know what's crazy about all of this shit with my YouTube channel? I asked God to give me a sign, you know, on what to do with my channel. I was like, you know, I really want to do the whole social issues thing, but I really want to go into motivation, advice, stuff like that. Because, like, I like doing the rant style advice videos. I like doing those because, like, people really ask me about that stuff all the time. And I think I really give good sound advice, right? And this happened, you know, where YouTube doing this bullshit with my channel. My channel get deleted. I feel like it's a sign to go in a different direction. I don't know what the direction is yet, but it's weird. I'm gonna stop asking God for signs because at this point it's scaring me. Every single time I ask God for a sign, he gives me a sign that I wasn't quite, I mean, I asked for a sign, but damn, God, I'm stressed. Give me a break. So now we have, this is for the phone. Now I probably might have to return this, so I'm not gonna like tear this open for real because, yeah. So how many of these shits do we need in life? Oh wow, this is actually heavy. This is metal. I've never got a metal one of these. And this is supposed to hold the phone and the camera.
Bro, this is so much easier than taking your camera apart. Look at this. Look how small this is. This is so much better.
Oh, okay. So this opens for however big your phone is. I don't know how big this gets.
So I would assume that this screws under and then, yeah, but it don't. I'm probably gonna get a screen protector and stuff with it because this shit is very fragile from what I understand, so.
My phone is not, it's not inserting. The peen is not going in the vag.
I'm confused. What the hell? This is not for my phone type, maybe? I don't know. Okay, return. I'm not tired. I'm not going to be playing guessing games with this shit. Y'all saw how small all of the pieces are. I'm confused. Okay, so I feel like it's going to be a while before I find. Oh, okay. This one fit right here. Perfect. I would like something that actually fits the goddamn pieces.
Okay, I think it works just fine
when I actually calm down and think. This is gonna make vlogging so fun. I'm already like excited to vlog because I don't have to worry about big pieces. Now this right here, I have no idea how this is gonna work. Like I'm trying to like lay it like right here, but it's not. And as for memory cards, I already have a memory card in here that I'm gonna use for vlogging. Primarily it's 256 gigabytes, which I think is enough. It fits. Oh my God, it's perfect. I absolutely love it. Oh my God, okay. This case is actually cute. I actually have the same case for my Beats pill. I just don't know where it is because clearly I don't use it. I only use it when I travel, to be honest with you. All right, it actually works. It works perfect. This can go right in my bags. It could go right in my backpacks. Oh my God, I'm so happy. So we're definitely gonna be doing way more vlogs, whether it's gonna be on the new channel or this channel. I'm so excited. Like I said, make sure you guys go subscribe to that. That is the end of this vlog. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys. Thank you for sticking with me. Thank you for always supporting me. Thank you for watching this very boring vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope Milagro some way somehow makes this entertaining for you guys. If you guys follow me on Instagram, stay updated with what's going on. Join the Discord and just peek the description box for everything that you guys always ask me about down below. That being said, I'ma see y'all next time. Bye!